Hello friends, you are watching ERUDIRE PLUS, the professional CAD-CAM solution provider. Let's get started.
Hello viewers, today I'm going to show CFD analysis through a hydroelectric power plant. This is a PhD project actually. And in this case, our outcome will be a little bit different compared to the actual project. And here in this case, we'll be using SolidWorks free surface technique. Right, the tank is having a height of near about 25 meter. And it is situated at a higher altitude, and from the left opening will provide water at high velocity, and it will pass through the pipe. And at the right hand side, water will be collected and it will pass through this turbine, and high water energy will be utilized to rotate the turbine, and that will produce electricity. And in this case, one big tank is there, that is known as actually surge tank. This tank is having high importance in this case, because to reduce the pulsation of pressure and also water hammer, this surge tank is utilized actually. Surge tank may be of different types. Generally, the surge tanks actually are open type. In this case, we have done something extra. That means inside this surge tank, we have taken some part filled up with water and remaining part filled up with air. In this case, our aim will be to see the pulsation of pressure, velocity, and also mass fraction of water and air separately. That will be checked inside this chamber. By the same time, we'll see all the things throughout this pipe also, right? So without wasting time, let us start our analysis. And it will be started from flow simulation here. And flow simulation environment will be created with the wizard itself. Let us start with wizard. And we are keeping the name of the project as project 2. Next to that, we need to select init systems, and we are considering this one as SI system. And from parameters, we can select that pressure should be in Pascal. Temperature is not important in this case. Anyway, we are considering temperature as degree Celsius. Next to that, we need to select what type of analysis it is. It is an internal analysis, and we are considering fluid flow. We are considering gravity, and direction of gravity will be Y, as indicated by this green arrow. So along Y, it will be minus 9.81 meter per second square, and along Z, it will be 0. Finally, it will be a free surface technique, as we are considering water and air in the same domain. As it is a free surface technique, it will be dependent on time. So it is a transient analysis. We are considering this one as time dependent, and the specific time will be provided later on. Next to that, gaseous, it will be air, and liquid, it will be water. So it is showing immiscible mixture of water and air. Next to that, default wall thermal conditions and roughness, it is not having that much of effect in this case. So we are considering default values of all these things. And next to that, thermodynamic parameters, we are considering temperature as 20 degrees centigrade and pressure as 0.1 megapascal, and concentration, initially it is filled up with air. Let us finish this. You can see this is the fluid domain, but it is not showing the complete fluid domain. So to have the complete fluid domain, what we have to do is, let us hide it. To have the complete fluid domain of water and air, we need to start with initial conditions, and we need to select water from here itself. That can be taken from here, solid bodies. We have selected this part and that part. This is composed of water only. So this solid will be disabled as solid component, and that to be considered as water only. So what we have done is, while making the CAD geometry, we have made this part solid. This was unmerged solid, and this solid we have made disabled, and from initial conditions we have made this one composed of water, right? Grain check. Now we can see the computational domain will be changed. Let us see the computational domain. Edit definition. Now we can move to 2D and 3D simulation. You can see the computational domain is changed. So it is a computational domain composed of water and air, two different fluids are in the same domain, right? Grand check. Now we can apply our boundary conditions. Boundary conditions, insert boundary condition. It will be inlet velocity of water from this opening. Select other, selected, and we are providing inlet velocity as 30 meter per second from this one, and it will be composed of water only. So substance concentration, you can check it from here itself, it will be water. Grain check. Next to that, we need to apply another boundary condition at the exit of this pipe. As we have told already that the source tank is actually closed at the top end. Generally, it should not be closed, but we have provided something else because we have considered some portion of this source tank is filled up with water and some portion is filled up with air. So there is no meaning to make it open. Now the other end of this pipe, it should be having one opening. Insert boundary condition. It will be environmental pressure or atmospheric pressure at the exit. Select other, selected, grain check. So both the boundary conditions are applied. Next to that, we need to apply our goals, right? We can have a lot of goals, but our aim should be to have pulsation of pressure. That means we want to see pressure variation, velocity, even mass fraction of water, volume fraction of water, air, etc. inside this tank. By the same time, we'll see all the same thing through this pipe also, right? For selecting the goals, let us have a segmented view of this model. Then you can select it in a better way. Let us cut the model from front plane and insert goals. It will be surface goals. At these surfaces, we want to have average pressure, average temperature of fluid, average velocity. These are the main things you want to see from the source tank. Let's select that specific surface, and this surface also at the top surface also want to see. So we want to see these things separately. Phase one is the top surface and phase two is the interface, and you want to create goals for each of them separately. By the same time, we want to see all these things at the exit location also. Select other, and selected. So we want to create goals for each of the surfaces separately. First one is the at the top surface, second one is the interface, and third one is the exit of this pipe. Next to that, to have better results, we can go for better meshing. So let us mesh it. Insert local mesh, and we are refining up to fourth level. Let us select that local mesh surface. Green check. Meshing is done. And next to that, we need to do something else, like from solve, we need to select calculation control options, and we need to run this one for 10 seconds. And from saving options, we need to select periodic, and we can select parameters like pressure, temperature, etc. Excluding that, you can select something else like immiscible air, immiscible water, mass fraction of air, mass fraction of water, and also we can select volume fraction of water and air separately, right? Okay, done. Now we can run it. Iterations have already started. Let the iterations move on. Whenever it is finished, we'll see the results and go for detailed analysis, right? For seeing the results, first of all, we need to select the transient explorer on, and we want to see different curves of pressure, velocity, etc. First of all, we want to see cut plots of pressure through different planes. So insert cut plot, and we want to see pressure distribution through front plane. Green check. So you can see pressure throughout this pipe is almost constant, it is not varying that much. So pressure at the tank is very less, but throughout the pipe it is very high. You can see it through the transient export also. Let us see velocity distribution instead of pressure. This is 2D cut plots. Velocity also you can see through the pipe, it is almost constant. At the beginning itself velocity is very high, but other places velocity is very low, it is constant almost. Let us close it, and we can see something else, like instead of velocity you can see immiscible water and also mass fraction of water. We can check it. Let us see mass fraction of water first. Inside the tank also we can see how water is varying, and we can see some pulsation of pressure inside this tank. But through the pipe, pressure is almost constant, which is desired actually. To reduce the pulsation pressure inside this pipe only, we have applied this tank, right? This is the mass fraction of water inside this tank. Next to that, instead of mass fraction of water, we can see immiscible water. Let us see that. You can see some kind of pulsation of pressure is definitely there inside this tank, so that's why you can see this sloshing effect inside this surge tank. Let us edit this one and clear and hide this one. Clear and hide. Next to that, you want to see surface plots, and it will be 3D representation. It will be through the boundaries of this object. You want to see immiscible water, and color will change it to black, and we will use all surface. Let us see this one through transient explorer again. It is the representation at the boundary. You can see pulsation of pressure and velocity etc. through the tank. And through the pipe it is almost constant, it is not varying that much, but through the tank it is varying, right? You can see, we can see some sloshing effect also. It will be better to view from front plane. If we have a segmented view, it will be better to understand again. Let's cut it from front plane and we can see it. Or you can do one thing, you can change the color to view this one in a better way. Let us edit this one, surface plots, edit definition, and you want to change the color from black to red. Grand check. Let us see through transient explorer in the form of an animation. We can see fluctuation of pressure and sloshing effect inside this tank. At different times you can see a different level of fluctuation or pressure development inside this tank. Here in this case we have run this one for 10 seconds. Actually initially we thought of planning this one for 30 seconds, but for simulation it is taking too much of time, so we reduce the time from 30 seconds to 10 seconds. Right. Next to that, we'll see something else. We'll see XY plot. That means at different levels of height or different lengths, what will be the fluctuation of pressure, velocity, etc. We can see it, right? Let us close it. Clear and hide this one. Next to that, we'll see XY plots. Insert XY plot, and we can view a lot of things like pressure, velocity, immiscible water, air, etc. Everything we can see. But we'll see only two things, pressure and velocity, through different lengths or different heights. That height can be viewed from here. You can check it. Initially, you'll see through the tank itself, and we can transport this data to Excel. And we want to see pressure and velocity through different height of this tank. Export to Excel, and we want to see two results: pressure and velocity as height is increasing inside the tank. You can see this is the velocity. As height is increasing, you can see velocity is increasing. So actually the tank is near about 25 meter height, and you can see here initially at the base level velocity is near about 10.4 meter per second, and at the top height velocity of water is in the range of 40.55 meter per second. So as height is increasing, velocity of water is also increasing, right? And let us see the next one, pressure distribution. At the ground level, pressure is very less, and as height is increasing, pressure is very high. At the top level, you can see pressure is in the range of 12.5 megapascal, right? Let us close it. At different level, you can see pressure is different. Initially, pressure variation was linear up to the height of 22.66 meter. After that, pressure increased with a high rate. Next to that, you want to see this fluctuation of pressure and velocity through the length of this pipe, right? So we'll change the height to the length of this one. Let us export to Excel. Now we'll see the fluctuation of pressure and velocity through the length of this pipe. First one is velocity. Initially, at the entry of this pipe, velocity was 30 meter per second, and up to 20 meter, the velocity was almost constant. Then velocity has decreased. At the exit level, we can see velocity is very, very less. It is in the range of 0.228 meter per second. Next one is pressure distribution through the pipe. Let us see that one. Initially, pressure was very less, and when the length is approximately 24 meter, then pressure increased at a higher rate. And finally, at the exit level, pressure is extremely high. It is in the range of 8.26 megapascal. It's very high, right? Excluding these things, also we can see some other things like temperature of fluid or mass fraction of water and air separately. All these things can be viewed in Excel, and that can be analyzed in a better way, right? Let us close it. And you can see all these goalposts also, what we decided from here, goalposts. Let us see all these goalposts also. Insert, that can be exported to Excel, or we can see it from here itself also. Let us see it from here itself. We can select all the goals and let us show. And that can be viewed in the form of Excel also. We have already seen these things that can be viewed in the form of graph. So this is all about our today's analysis. This is a very simple analysis of hydroelectric power plant. And in this case, we have considered the surge tank. We tried to show the pulsation of pressure and velocity distribution through the tank. Okay. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you again. Bye. If you like this video, please subscribe and share. And if you have any kind of doubts, please write to me. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you again. Bye.